we begin this episode with a two-game highlight reel. The first one here being against FC 20, where we just dominated, getting assists left and right. And at the end of the game, the final score was 3-0. Then we moved into a game up against the Chelsea. And in this game, we just scored an early goal. And yeah, we scored the goal and we just dominated the rest of the game. So let's get into this episode and start. Going on our usual morning run. We always do this just to stay active, just to stay fit. We're a midfielder, we have to be one of the most fit players on the team. I've done this every day for basically my whole life. And when I got home, there was something big waiting for me. Yes, lads, we've been called up to the Polish national team. This is big, guys. And this just shows that we have made progress since the first game of the season. And now we find ourselves flying back to Poland to play, to get ready to play our first game. Our first game is actually away up against Austria. So yeah, I think we'll be connecting some flights going to Austria. But guys, we've been dreaming about this. At only 16 years old, we are now about to be the youngest player to ever play for Poland. That's just insane, in my opinion. We just need to stay focused though, keep playing our game so we don't choke on the international level. Because that's where they'll see the real me. I'm creating impressions right here. I might just leave a bad remark if I'm not careful. So I just need to make sure, first of all, I do my thing, morning routine, running, everything. And when I play my best. Because I know people might say I'm too young, so I just need to show them that I am mature enough to play and represent the Polish national team. But as you can see, we took the connecting flight from Poland to Austria. And we are getting ready because these might be some friendlies, but it is our debut, so we want to really perform. And we are gonna get into that now, playing against Austria. We've come on as a sub and we are already making a difference as their keeper makes a good save there and we're pushing for a winner and a chance to do so. A goal by Lukas Bartikowski on his international debut off the bench. How often do you see that? Wow. And now, as the minutes are running out, they tried to get on one more attack, but there was no time remaining, and we ended up getting the dub. That's all that matters. And I don't know if you saw, but we came on as a captain. Wow. The captain didn't give the armband to anyone else, and we played captain on our debut. Just imagine if we could do that, play captain for our country. Yeah, that'd just be noise. But guys, we ended up getting the win, and yeah, maybe people, they weren't congratulating me as much, but I was happy for myself. As we got into the next game, we were playing up against England, and this time didn't come on as a captain because we played a different position. But yeah, we are looking to win this game, and they had a chance early on to score from a free kick, but our keeper made a save. And then from a corner, they crossed it in, and they made the score 2-0. And just like that, England made it 2, and there's nothing we could do. It was just a good header past our keeper. So we move on. We try and maybe get a consolation goal because this game is probably over. But England kept attacking, and yeah, Jadon Sancho made it 3, and this is just embarrassing. Losing 3-0 at home in front of the Poland fans who had to work their A's off to get to this game. But yeah, can't be too mad. You just need to appreciate that we got to play for this huge country and got the opportunity. Bartikowski on the field, he was a little bit more sad than the others, but you know, he had to cheer up because, I mean, he is 16. He has a lot of time to play for the country. But guys, yeah, went to the dressing room. Everyone was pretty disappointed, but we move on. Before moving back home, we were invited to a party by our teammate Ark Kuzan Milik, and as you can see by the messages, he told us that we had to dress casual while everyone was formal. I don't know if this was just to prank us, but everyone laughed, and I don't think they like me. So yeah, what we did, we just left, went home, and we got a call from none other than legend Justin Klaassen. What do you guys think he called about? There are many things. Maybe he wants to speak to us in person. Maybe he liked how we played. I don't know. But we'll see later in this episode. That's coming up. But first, we have to make our UCL debut. Up against Besiktas, we are looking to win our first ever UCL game. Hopefully we can complete all our objectives and get the 3 points that we need. But without further ado, let's hear the UCL anthem. And now, this game begins. Playing against Besiktas away, hopefully we can get the dub. As right now, it's great passing into Bartikowski. Can he score? No, he can't. And straight after that, yep, their number 23 makes it 1-0 to Besiktas. This is bad because we need to win this game. They're a weak team in our group, the group of death. We still have Dortmund and Sporting to play, and if we're losing games like this, we might not even have a chance against those other teams. But we keep our head up and we keep going. Corner kick for them, trying to make it two. Pass to Bartikowski. And look at this. Man is gone. Man is pacing as fast as he can. He's really quick. He's penetrating through. No defenders can catch him. And he scores his first Champions League goal of many. That's his golf celebration, as he loves golf, and we will continue to persevere. We can even win this game now. We are just attacking. We have the momentum. So what we need to do is just keep going, because yeah, this was a really good finish, and it's now 1-1. The fans have our back. We keep moving, but we need to just make sure Besiktas stop attacking. They have a corner right before half time, and it's straight to our keeper. The whistle is blown, and we go into the half. We need to keep going the way we are in order to try and get the win. But they are attacking. They haven't given up after their first goal. So we need to make sure that they don't score another, and another they will score from here. Onana, a bit of dodgy goalkeeping, but fair play. Goal well deserved. We need to keep going, but it wouldn't end there. Another chance for them. They make it 3-1. 70 minutes in, they've just torn us apart. Our defense has been weak this game. We haven't attacked enough. We haven't been switched on. And that was a well-deserved goal over there. But guys, maybe we can get maybe a consolation goal. Even a tie if we get another goal. Right now, it's Bartikowski. Can he get it? The ball is saved. And just like that, in the 90th minute, trying to get a consolation goal, the game would end 3-1 to Besiktas. What a game by them, to be fair. Couldn't really do anything. They just dominated. The Ajax fans are booing us off the pitch, and it has not been a great Champions League game for Bartikowski. Getting into some highlights up against Groningen. Hopefully, we can get the win here in the league. We might have not started well in the UCL, but we will continue to strive for that league title. And Bartikowski starts this game, as early on, he can score. Yes, he does. What a goal by Bartikowski to make the score 1-0 to Ajax. And he kept attacking. Great ball by Bartikowski, just inside, and then it was clean, just like that, from your boy Sebastian Haller. And yeah, that's how the game ended. And yeah, we're doing well in the league. Yes, lads, Justin Clarkson. He pulled up to our house. Remember the call earlier? He wanted to talk. And what he wanted to talk about was advice. Obviously, he also joined Ajax, same position as a youngster. And he talked about my attitude. We have to make sure we don't get caught up in the bad things, the drinking, the smoking. And it made sense because he got caught up in this, and this kind of made him a flop at the end. At Ajax, he obviously wasn't a flop, but when he moved on to bigger and better things, when he joined Everton, Arsenal, Juventus, yeah, it kind of didn't work out for him. So should we take this advice into heart, or is he just flattering? Because we need to make sure that we keep our career going. So we could take this advice too hard, or we could just go our own way. Personally, I think his advice is good, and the fact he took time out of his day to speak to us is good. But that's not what we're here for. We are here to watch some balls and a chance for an assist for Bartikowski. Anthony just couldn't get to the ball, but we keep striving. And another chance to make it 1-0. What a goal by Anthony, but another chance for the best goal of Bartikowski's career so far. special goal by Bartikowski to make this game 2-0 away against Dortmund in the UCL. Wow, after our first game the way we played, who would expect this? But, I mean, we can't talk too soon because Dortmund started attacking and just like that they made it 2-1. I'll go back in this game and it's not really late in the game yet. 55th minute. We just need to keep pressing, keep putting the pressure so they don't get another one and make sure they stop attacking. And attacking they did. They kept going. They kept trying to make an opportunity happen. But luckily, we are able to tackle and we are on the go. A great pass to Bartikowski. What would he do? He lays it back. And just like that, we seal the deal in the 74th minute. It is Anthony who gets the goal and Bartikowski grabs him in celebration as we have won this UCL tie against Dortmund, a very famous win as we keep in our pursuit to get out of the group of death. But they maybe tried to get a goal back, you know, to maybe lower the goal difference. But I mean, yeah, we cleared it nicely. Tried to go on the attack. Bartikowski on the run. Great through ball. And it goes back to Bartikowski. He tries to find the pass at the far post. He can't. And just like that, the game would end 3-1 to us. Away win up against Dortmund. Something we love to see. They didn't have the best of games, but we pounced on that. And we bounced back from our first game against the Besiktas in the ECL. And we keep striving for victory as games will keep coming and we need to get the wins. And yeah, as you can see, we were happy in the dressing room. Bartikowski got the man of the match, but more good news was to come as we got an offer from New Balance. I know, amazing. I might have messed up with the per week thing, it's actually per year. But what do you guys think? I think this is a good offer. Some free money, no other boot sponsor has offered us. And these are the boots we could be wearing. I don't know. Your choice in the comments. We find out our father, well, he's coming to the Netherlands. He originally moved back to Poland because of the war ending and now he's on the first flight back to the Netherlands to see me. And actually he could be moving here because he's coming for a business opportunity. Wow, something you love to see. Bartikowski could be reunited with his father as for a few years now he's been living, not with foster parents, he's kind of lived alone despite being so young. Because of the age you could live by yourself in the Netherlands is pretty low. And he's been living in his own apartment, he's been funded and everything. And now he's excited because his father has arrived in the Netherlands. As you can see here, he is by arrivals, waiting to be picked up by Bartikowski as he has his business meeting the next day. But that next day, something would happen that could change the life of Lukas Bartikowski.